wedding of Jason Pavlika and Jill McDowell. This one has been a long time coming, so I want to start off with just a round of applause for these two wonderful people who we are here for today.
Jill, you look absolutely beautiful. Just stunning. A round of applause for Jill, please. Just gorgeous. I'm used to Pittsburgh weddings where the bride usually wears camouflage, so this is just absolutely stunning, Jill. I want to start today just by us all kind of looking around and being grateful for the love that these two share that has brought all of us here together. You know, we had some rain a little bit earlier for luck. We have some sun for fun, and I think it's going to be a beautiful day, and I just want to thank both of you for having me here. And I think we should all thank them for bringing us all together for this joyous occasion, right?
Jill and Jason Pavlika, everyone!
Now that I can catch my breath, I figured I would give you a little walkthrough in terms of what I did for ceremony and now cocktail hour. So cocktail hour is going on right now. I am using my same ceremony setup, which was the Electro-Voice Evolve 30M with an RE3 BBT body pack, a simple iPad, a little Hercules controller, and everyone, this is probably the best thing, other than maybe my Infinity DJ console, that I've ever done for myself. It has a crazy small footprint, amazing sound. As I said in other videos, the Electro-Voice 30M has a 120 degree coverage, so this whole patio area is getting a nice consistent sound. I simply rotated it around for the ceremony. The microphone was great, it was clear. I literally couldn't be happier. So this is the outdoor section, and then I am using a Sennheiser EW100G4 mic and running a wireless Evolve 30M right here in the corner. So now everybody in this room hears the same thing that they hear outside. And then I just got another 3D printed shelf and just put the base of the Sennheiser EW100 right here, and now it's picking up the signal. And now we have a remote wireless cocktail hour speaker for all the guests in here. It was raining earlier, it finally cleared up, it's not very hot, low humidity, couldn't have asked for a nicer day. So I'm gonna get back to work, but yeah, this is what I have going on outside, and I literally couldn't be happier. So I assume I'm going to be asked how I'm getting the satellite speaker to work. So as I said, I am using the Sennheiser EW100G4. Just kind of tuck that right in here. And then I'm using the mix out on the back of the Evolve 30M. And then if we come to the other speaker. Simply coming out of the base and into input one, and then I can adjust the gain and volume right here. And it's that simple, folks. So with just using this unit, I have a pretty much plug and play satellite cocktail hour speaker.
I am interrupting your regularly scheduled program to bring you this friendly PSA from the comfort of my favorite hammock chair in my backyard. Party girl hair and all, I just woke up from yesterday's wedding and realized that there was something I wanted to say before letting you watch the rest of this video. So you may have noticed when I showed you my 30M cocktail hour speaker where I had the Sennheiser mic base on that 3D printed shelf, that may have looked a little weird. Well, that's because I made the fatal mistake of leaving this in the car. So I usually pack my car a couple days early before the event, and I had these 3D printed shelves made for the 30M, and obviously 3D printed plastic can change its shape with the heat. So I left these in the car, and then when I got to the event, I realized that the shelf was completely misshapen. I then messed around with it and actually I ended up breaking it. So I reached out to my friend Todd Hill, who makes these shelves. I told him how stupid I was, and he is being kind enough to make me another shelf. I'm ordering another one. So I just wanted to let you all know that if you have anything that is 3D printed, do not leave it in the car because it's going to get misshapen and not work out so well. So this is your friendly PSA letting you know to not leave dogs, babies, and 3D printed products in your car. So now back to your regularly scheduled program.
It is my honor and absolute privilege to finally introduce to you, as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Pavlika!
Venue in case anybody DJs here in the future. So I am at Aria in Prospect. It's absolutely gorgeous, but the acoustics are one of the most challenging I've had to deal with. It's pretty much all marble in here with this convex. I think that's a convex ceiling. I don't know. Someone's probably gonna fact check me later. Either which way, the sound is very challenging. I have two ETX 18 SP subs and two ETX 10P tops just to kind of fill out the space. And they are barely turned up just because I want to minimize the echo and stuff during dinner. We're definitely gonna rock later, but acoustically, this has been a big challenge. So anyway, I'm gonna get back to work, just checking in, and stay tuned for the party. So the moral of this story, folks, is if you don't have Hold On in your wedding dinner sing-along crate, you're missing out on a banger. It's time for the vendor meal. And because this bride is pretty much the best bride, she knows me pretty well. And guess who has their own personal pizza?
That would be me.
Well, maybe I'm sharing it with the photographer too. I'm not really sure.
She's a hungry kid, a dog, and a toy.
You'd be stupid not to hire her.
She's the greatest,
best ever DJ.
Everybody at my reception said, amazing job, best music, best everything that they've ever had. And
DJ Rachel.
She performed exactly how I wanted, and I couldn't ask for anything better.
Thank you. So, group hug.
Group hug.
Did you have a good time, everybody?
Yeah.